Hi everyone. So today I'm going to make a video on how to study for polity for prelims. Now, most of you already know that polity is a very important subject for UPSC preparation because almost 15 to 20 questions in prelims are coming just from polity. And there are only 2 to 3 books that you really need to study. So therefore, you can score very, very high marks in polity section in these 15 to 20 questions for prelims, which almost guarantees you qualifying for mains. And secondly, from mains perspective, see, if you are a serious aspirant, you're also of course preparing for mains. So for mains perspective, polity is very important because in GS2, lot of conceptual questions or lot of current affairs based polity questions are going to come. Okay, and for that, you need to have a very strong foundation. Very strong foundation you need to have, very strong नींव, जैसे कहते हैं ना घर की नींव बहुत मजबूत होना चाहिए ताकि घर अच्छा सा बने, अच्छा सा टिका रहे। इसी तरह से मुझे लगता है कि पॉलिटी जैसे सब्जेक्ट में तो आपकी फाउंडेशन बहुत स्ट्रांग होनी चाहिए। लॉट ऑफ अस आर इंजीनियर्स, लॉट ऑफ अस आर कॉमर्स बैकग्राउंड पर्सन्स हु कम एंड प्रिपेयर फॉर UPSC, वी माइट नॉट हैव एवर स्टडीड पॉलिटी। फॉर देम स्पेशली इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट टू स्टडी polity very well from the foundation so that you can do very well in it. So this video is going to talk about Indian Constitution at Work. This is a class 11th NCERT book for polity, which I recommend very highly before you read Lakshmikant. Lakshmikant is a great book, of course it is the Bible of polity, but before you read Lakshmikant you have to read this book. Why? Because Lakshmikant goes straight into facts, straight into all the relevant facts. It goes directly into very heavy stuff which you need to know. But before you get to know that, if you read this book, it will become much easier to read that Lakshmikant book. Okay, so I am going to go through this video. I am going to go through some of the chapters and the table of contents of Indian Constitution at Work. So watch this video carefully. Because every minute of this video is going to help you a lot when it comes to polity and making your life easier for studying polity for civil services exams. So let us go through Indian Constitution at Work. Let us go through specifically what are the various contents of this book so that you can plan accordingly. This is the NCERT book. You can easily download it from NCERT website where it is available for free. The PDF form you can download it. Of course, not for reproduction, but you can use it for your own study matters. Here, as I go down, all this is not useful for your purposes. Just go straight to the table of contents. Also, one thing I would like to tell you is, ek cheez mereko NCERT books ki bahut achhi jo lagti hai, that is Constitution of India preamble jo hai wo hum hamesha table of contents se pehle dete hain. You can always read through this preamble because this is something you need to really know by heart. You need to know all the different components, that what does justice mean, what does liberty mean, what does equality mean, what does fraternity mean. All these are different concepts and they mean different things. Okay, so if you know this, you should also know when it was enacted, when it was adopted by the Constituent Assembly. So it is, if you go through your NCERT books or every time you read the Constitution of India's preamble once, after a few times you will remember it. Okay, chalo, let's go to the contents. Ye book mujhe bahut achhi isliye bhi lagti hai, it is very well written, it is very small, only about 200 pages ki book hai ye, sirf 10 chapters hain. To agar aap roz ek ya do chapter padhenge to maximum to maximum aap 10 din ke andar ya fir 8 days ke andar ye puri book read kar sakte hain. 200 pages within 10 days is not that hard. Aur इसको आप एक दो बार नहीं, कम से कम 5 बार इस बुक को पढ़िए. मैंने कम से कम 5-6 बार बुक पढ़ी थी क्योंकि इंटरेस्टिंग है, इजी टू रीड है और बहुत सारा कॉन्टेक्स्ट और बहुत सारी अंडरस्टैंडिंग देती है कि इंडियन पॉलिटी डेवलप कैसे हुई, हाउ डिड द इंडियन पॉलिटी एक्चुअली इवॉल्व ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. दैट इज व्हाट दिस बुक टेल्स यू एंड इट ऑल्सो गिव्स यू अ पीक इनटू द फंडामेंटल कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ इंडियन पॉलिटी एंड द इंडियन पॉलिटिक्स. सो फर्स्ट चैप्टर, you can start directly from first chapter and go chronologically. You don't have to really go one by one here and there, which I recommend for Lakshmikant. For that, I'm going to make another video. But you can just go one by one. So Constitution, why and how? That is the first chapter, around 26 pages. Rights in the Indian Constitution. See, now I will tell you the difference between Lakshmikant and this particular book, Constitution at Work. Lakshmikant mein seedha rights mein ghus jate hain and they will tell you important rights, okay? They will go through the important articles, but they don't explain to you where the concept of right comes from, how it has evolved, what does it mean, what value does it carry for the citizens, and exactly how it has been framed by the constitution makers. This book really gives you a very good insight into that. In fact, for any law students who are thinking of law school, I really highly suggest this book. This is one of my favorite books, all-time favorite books out there. So why and how the constitution, for rights ke baare mein baat kari hai, for election ke baare mein baat kari hai, for executive, legislature and judiciary, these are the three pillars of Indian democracy, uske baare mein baat kari hai. Then what is the concept of federalism? Questions, lot of questions, almost 3-4 questions I saw last year appeared from this book. Jaise constitution ke baare mein, federalism ke baare mein. Local governments kya hoti hain? What are the amendments that actually led to local governments in India? Phir, how is constitution? What does a living document mean? Okay. What does a living document mean? That they are going to explore in this book and the philosophy of the constitution. Extremely important, interesting book for any UPSC aspirant. Go through the table of contents so that आपको एक idea मिल जाता है. ये fundamental duties बताई हैं यहाँ पर. Preamble के बाद आपको fundamental duties भी बताई गई हैं आप. And I think you should go through them. Really important. You should know all of them if you are a UPSC aspirant. Okay. So here is the table of contents. Let's go through the different chapters. So before I actually go to the chapters, एक मैं बहुत key point आपको बताना चाहता हूँ कि watch the whole video क्योंकि काफी सारे tips और tricks मैंने इसमें आगे बताई हैं. कि प्रीलिम्स में पॉलिटी के क्वेश्चंस कैसे आते हैं इस बुक से और लक्ष्मीकांत से पहले ये बुक क्यों पढ़नी चाहिए वो सब मैंने एक्सप्लेन करा है. तो वॉच द होल वीडियो, अदरवाइज आप स्किप कर देंगे तो फिर आप बहुत सारी चीज़ें देख नहीं पाएंगे. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वाई एंड हाउ. ओके, इन द फर्स्ट पेज इट विल टेल यू द इंट्रोडक्शन दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर व्हाट विल यू बी स्टडिंग. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स यू विल बी स्टडिंग, व्हाट ए कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन मीन्स, what a constitution does to the society, how constitutions govern the allocation of power in society, and what was the way in which constitution of India was made. Now, if you remember, a question had come in prelims directly from one of these topics. I will tell you about that question. So here I have downloaded the 2020 paper of prelims, and I'm going to show you how the polity questions, some very important questions, the easier questions have actually been picked from Constitution at Work, and these are basic fundamental questions. So this is a series, and come to question number 7. Question number 7 is, a constitutional government by definition is a government by legislature, popular government, multi-party government, or a limited government. So this question is a very straightforward question. It's an easy question. But a lot of times, a lot of candidates are not able to answer these kind of fundamental questions. Why? Because they have only read Lakshmikant. And this kind of question, this kind of concept is not available in Lakshmikant. They are never discussed in Lakshmikant. So that is one of the main things. In Lakshmikant, you will not get this in Lakshmikant. सिर्फ फैक्चुअल पॉलिटी का जो क्वेश्चंस मिलेंगे, कंसेप्चुअल नहीं मिलेंगे. और इस बार के पेपर में बहुत सारे ऐसे फैक्चुअल नहीं बल्कि कंसेप्चुअल क्वेश्चंस आए थे. तो ये कहाँ पर है चैप्टर 1 में, लेट मी शो यू. सो आई एम बैक टू चैप्टर 1. हियर इन चैप्टर 1, इफ यू गो अहेड एंड स्टार्ट रीडिंग द चैप्टर, ओके, इफ यू गो अहेड एंड स्टार्ट रीडिंग द चैप्टर, जस्ट ऑन द सेकेंड पेज देर इज वाई डू वी नीड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन जस्ट स्टार्टिंग, एंड दिस clarifies the concepts. This chapter clarifies the concepts of constitution, why and how a constitution comes to existence, and what functions does it have. Aakhirkar constitution hota kya hai, constitutionalism kya hota hai, and how it works. So in this, the first reason they have given is constitution allows coordination and assurance. Basically, it creates rules that allows a society to function with minimum coordination, with minimal coordination amongst members of a society. So it allows for coordination rules. That is the first point that is there for constitution to exist, the one of the reasons for it to exist and one of its functions. Okay. Similarly, then it gives you the second reason, which is specification of decision-making powers. So when you read this whole chapter, of course, you will get a better idea. Abhi main aapko seedha thoda sa jaldi bata raha hu, kyunki I do not have the time to read this entire chapter for you or to make you understand this. So if you look at the second function, which is specification of powers, decision-making powers, basically what that means is it specifies power structure of a country. That means is the one of the functions of the constitution is to tell you that how the government of the country will be constituted. Jaise judiciary kya hogi aur uski powers kya hongi, executive kya hogi uski powers kya hongi, legislature kya hoga uski powers kya hongi. Ye sab constitution define karta hai. Uske baad third point is, or the third function of the constitution is limitations on the power of the government. Okay. It limits the government. Basically, a constitutional democracy is a limited already. The government has limited powers when it comes to a constitutional democracy. Now, it is a kind of a not an easy point to get. It's a counter intuitive, right? You think government has all the power. But no, in a constitutional government type of democracy, the power of the government is limited. Why? Because the constitution says, what rights will people have? Constitution says, what are the limitations of each of the different branches of the government? What they can do and what they cannot do. And what they cannot do is more important than what they can do. So the third function of a constitution is to set some limits on what a government can impose on the citizens. What kind of restrictions it can impose. Okay, it limits are fundamental in the sense the government may never trespass them. So basically, and this whole idea of a limited government comes from the American Constitution, that the government should not be all powerful. It should be limited in the way it can act in a society so that it does not overwhelm the citizens or the people. Okay. So after reading these 3 points, it should be clear to you that you can answer that question very easily. In fact, when you read more chapters in this book, your fundamentals will become so clear that you will right away answer that question. So I will go back to that question now. So now I'm back on this question. A constitutional government by definition is a government by legislature. Now we read in the chapter ahead that constitution defines the power of legislature, defines the powers of judiciary and executive. So of course it is not a government by legislature. The legislature does not define the powers of a constitution. It is the other way around. So your option is galat. Then we have popular government. No, a constitutional government by definition is not a necessarily popular government. Ye aapko chapter mein baad mein pata lagega aur book ke aur chapter mein pata lagega kaise ki popular government can be any type of government. It doesn't have to be necessarily a constitutional government. Okay, so by definition it is not a popular government. Is it a multi-party government? No. Again, why? Because there are single party democracies or single party countries, single party governments in some countries where there is no constitution or there is constitution. So that by definition is not necessarily a constitutional government. So the last option is limited government. And we saw this in one of the functions of the constitution. There are limits the power of the government. So yes, the constitutional government by definition is a limited government. Matlab koi bhi constitutional democracy agar hogi to wo automatically a limited government hogi, kyunki the whole idea of constitution is to create a limited government. Okay, so ye type ke jo questions hain, is type ke questions wo aap kabhi bhi Lakshmikant se nahi nikal sakte. Isliye maine aapse kaha tha video puri tarah dekhen, because only then you will understand that what actually are these concepts that are hidden in this kind of book and chapters which a lot of people don't read. Similarly, there are other questions in this book, in this prelims paper, like question 4 and 5. In India, separation of judiciary from executive is enjoined by preamble, directive, principle, 7th schedule, conventional practice. Isko solve kariye, puri book padhiye, constitution at work. Ab mujhe fir bataiye ye kaun sa chapter se, ye bhi wahin se uthaya gaya hai. Similarly, ye wala hai. Which one of the following categories of fundamental rights incorporates protection against untouchability as a form of discrimination? Again, same. It has also been picked up from this book. Okay. So let us now take a look at the rights in the Indian Constitution. This अगेन यहाँ पर बहुत अच्छी समरी दी गई है कि वॉट आर द वेरियस फंडामेंटल राइट्स इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, हाउ आर दिस प्रोटेक्टेड, राइट, वॉट आर द पर्टिकुलर सेक्शंस इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया दैट प्रोटेक्ट आर फंडामेंटल राइट्स, वॉट इज द रोल ऑफ द जुडिशरी एंड वॉट इज द डिफरेंट बिटवीन एफआरएस एंड डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ स्टेट पॉलिसी. ये क्वेश्चन प्रीलिम्स में बहुत बार आ चुका है, इनफैक्ट मेन्स में भी आ चुका है कि फंडामेंटल राइट्स और डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स में डिफरेंसेस क्या हैं. So when you start this, they will give you very nice examples also, and through that you can come to understand what is Bill of Rights. So it will give you an example of foreign countries also, or how different countries came about with their constitution and how Indian constitution got inspired, which is part of the main syllabus. अब Indian constitution पे आए हैं, उसकी थोड़ी सी आपको background दिया है उन्होंने कि historically ये कैसे आया, कौन सी कमिटी थी जिसने बिल ऑफ राइट्स पहला बनाया था 1928 में. ये प्रीलिम्स में आ सकता है क्वेश्चन. ऐसे ही उन्होंने साउथ अफ्रीकन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के बारे में बात करी है, जैसा मैंने आपको अभी बताया. साउथ अफ्रीकन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के बारे में क्यों बात करी है, इट इज़ ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट टू नो बिकॉज अपार्थियड था, गांधी जी की लाइफ वहाँ पर शुरू हुई थी, पॉलिटिकल लाइफ, तो इसलिए ये अब साउथ अफ्रीका इंडियन कॉन्टेक्स्ट में बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. फिर आप आएंगे राइट टू इक्वालिटी से शुरू होता है, इक्वालिटी, उसमें दे गिव यू वेरी लाइट एग्जांपल्स, फटाफट पढ़ सकते हैं, और फिर आपको ये डिफरेंट राइट्स के बारे में बताता है चैप्टर, एक्सप्लॉयटेशन के अगेंस्ट, इक्वालिटी राइट्स, फ्रीडम राइट्स, रिलीजन राइट्स, एजुकेशन राइट्स, कल्चरल राइट्स एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रेमेडीज, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट राइट. सो ऑल दीज आर प्रोवाइडेड एंड देन All these rights are being talked about, that what it means, and it also tells you what equality means, what freedom means, what are the difference between these two, how they kind of depend on each other, equality versus freedom. There's always a big debate in polity, so you should also kind of understand that. Okay, preventive detention, ye question kitni baar aa chuka hai. They give you this wonderful, one thing I forgot to mention is they give you this wonderful quotes from the actual Constitution Assembly debates. अगर आप CAD देखें तो ये Constituent Assembly की जो debates हुई थी, उन debates से excerpt निकाले हैं कुछ prominent people के, freedom fighters and politicians of that time, who really had this inspiring and very insightful quotes. आप इनको use करके mains के answers में भी डाल सकते हैं, इनकी एक summary बना के कि what it talks about and then attribute to Somnath Lahiri will form great content from mains. मैंने भी ऐसे करा था. Accused के Indian में rights क्या हो सकते हैं, preventive detention के against, ठीक है, exploitation, all this is being talked about very nicely here. ये सब आपको लक्ष्मीकांत में नहीं मिलेगा. ओके, लेट मी गो डाउन. ऐसे ही यहाँ सरदार हुकुम सिंह, उन्होंने कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल असेंबली डिबेट्स में क्या कहा था इस पर्टिकुलर चीज के बारे में. कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रेमेडीज, ये लक्ष्मीकांत में भी चैप्टर है, पर इतनी अच्छे तरीके नहीं पढ़ाया जैसे यहाँ पे पढ़ाया है. बहुत सिंपल तरीके से आपको हेबियस कॉर्पस, मैंडामस, प्रोहिबिशन, को वारंट और सर्टियोरारी में डिफरेंसेस बताए हैं, विच आर की एंड माइट कम इन द एग्जाम. ओके, NHRC आ गया, उसके बाद DPSPs, What do they mean? What do they contain? तो शॉर्ट में बताया कि क्या क्या है उसमें, तो आप ये भी याद कर लेंगे तो ईजियर हो जाता है एक्चुअली मेन्स के क्वेश्चन को, सॉरी प्रीलिम्स के क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व करने के लिए उस. ओके, ये देखिए, ये सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट चीज़ आ गई यहाँ पर. ये इस टाइप की चीज़ों से क्वेश्चन आते हैं UPSC के, रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन फंडामेंटल राइट्स एंड डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स, ठीक है, दैट What are the various non-justiciable rights, indirective principles? What are its goals? What are its policies? So, जो इनका relationship है, जो complementarity है, जो थोड़ा सा conflict है, उसके बारे में यहाँ पर बात करी है. Okay, right to property इंडिया में नहीं exist करता, तो उसके बारे में बात करी है. So, ऐसे ही मैं आपको ये एक book के through लेके जाना था, ताकि आपको पता चले कि इस book की importance क्या है. एक अगर आप इस book को पढ़ेंगे, इसके chapters को अच्छी तरह समझेंगे, तो आपको बहुत फायदा होगा. Other than that, if you have any questions, let me know. This is for the video and I hope it helps you out. Take care. Bye.